Sapphire's Mocha Whip takes the regular whip pan transition and adds a more modern spice. Using AI-powered masks, you'll create dynamic and personalized transitions to add that extra bit of original creativity to your productions. I'm Grant K for Boris Effects, and let's check this out. Now, we all know that whip transitions are super popular. However, let me show you another way to crank up your edits and turn basic whip transitions into unique creativity using Sapphire's Mocha Whip Transition. This will work in any supported host, including VFX hosts. But since transitions are usually within an editor's domain, our focus will be mainly editorial. Starting in the timeline, we have two basketball shots edited together. To create a personalized whip transition between these shots, go to your effects tools, video transitions, and locate S Mocha Whip. Drag it onto the edit and set the duration to 15 frames. Playing the edit, you need to identify something from the two or incoming frames that will be highlighted in the transition. It's pretty obvious that we want number 42 before he slam dunks his next basket. So go back to the middle of the transition, and we are now going to Roto the player. The default input for tracking is set as 2, or the incoming frames, but you could track the from or outgoing frames if that's what you wanted. Click Edit Mocha to launch Sapphire Mocha. Now, we could manually Roto this player, but realistically for a transition, that's a big ask. So to make life super easy, we'll use MaskML and let the AI do the work for us. We'll choose the brush tool and click a couple of points on the player. The red overlay shows what MaskML intends to use for the cutout. This includes bits of the other players, which we don't want. To quickly fix this, change to the brush with the plus symbol. Using Command for Mac or Control for Windows, you can scale the size of your brush. Holding Option for Mac or Alt for Windows, paint away the areas you don't want MaskML to consider. This should take no more than a couple of seconds. Make sure you're back in the Object Brush mode and a Finish button will appear. Click that or the Pick tool to confirm the mask and a spline will be created. To track this mask over the transition, we'll use the MatAssistML to make short work of this. With Generate Object Mat enabled, analyze the movement in both directions. This creates an automatic mat for us. Now, the mat does not need to be 100%, but this will do nicely. We'll save the result by clicking on the Save button at the top and exit Sapphire Mocha. I know we have glossed over Sapphire Mocha, but we have plenty of tutorials on the Boris Effects channel that cover MaskML in Mocha. So please check them out for more in-depth explanations. Back in Premiere Pro, let's mark the region around the edit with I and O, and I'll set the playback to loop. Not bad for a couple minutes of work. But let's fine-tune the cutout and the whip effect. For starters, we'll go to the cutout's motion blur and set that to 0. This will make him stand out in the transition. As a tip, if you wanted to refine the alpha or matte of the cutout, you could access the Mocha tools in the effects controls. In this case, we don't need to. The cutout shift X and Y values are the directions and number of times that the cutout cycles during the transition. So 4 on X means that he moves from left to right 4 times over 15 frames. If you want him to whip in the opposite direction, from right to left, just set X to a negative value. Now let's change X to 3 times to slow him down a bit. Looping the edit, we can see how the personalization is much more effective on the whip transition. If we also wanted to refine the background of the transition, there are the corresponding background controls to change the shift direction, cycles, motion blur, and more. Let's slow the background by decreasing its shift value to -3. So that's how you can achieve a personalized whip transition with quick Roto and a few tweaks using the S Mocha Whip Transition controls. Let's take a look at other examples that are not sports related. How about cooking? Here we have two shots in a kitchen, and all I have done is rotoscoped the pan in Sapphire Mocha. Everything else is using the default S Mocha Whip settings. If we play this back, it looks pretty great. However, I'd like to show you how you can completely change the look of the effect. Let's say we want to add some vertical movement. So we'll select the transition and go to the effect controls. We'll set the cutout shift X to 0 and the cutout shift Y to 2. Let's also up the cutout's motion blur to 0.5. Playing the result, there is an interesting dynamic between the vertical and horizontal movements, giving a totally different look and feel compared to the first example. The last example we'll look at could be in any production, like social content, dance promos, or just part of a graphic design. Playing the example, you can see how the filming of the hands and the high angle of the dancer helps sell the S-Mocha Whip transition. To add a bit more artistic flair to this transition, you also have access to the background RGB blur and shift controls. Here, you can mix in the RGB blur with the background image and stylize the colors of the background throughout the transition. Another way of personalizing the look alongside the cutout. We haven't touched on every control of the Sapphire's Mocha Whip transition, but please go ahead and download the free trial of Sapphire and explore all the controls for yourself. If you have any questions or comments about the Sapphire Mocha Whip transition, please feel free to let us know in the comments. I'm Grant K for Boris FX, and see you later.